बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू अगेन ऑन एप्सिक्स ऑनलाइन सपोर्ट प्रोग्राम। क्लास 8 वीक 16, सब्जेक्ट इज केमिस्ट्री, प्रिपेयर्ड बाय अनीसुन्निसा। टेक्स्ट बुक केमिस्ट्री, फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 74 to 75। यूनिट नंबर 4, स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स, एंड द टॉपिक इज नेचर ऑफ बॉन्डिंग एंड इट्स प्रॉपर्टीज। The resources required are textbook, internet connection. Following video will help the students in understanding the concept. It is advised that student must watch the video under complete parental supervision. Objectives: by the end of the lesson, students will be able to know about ionic compounds, nature of ionic compounds, and properties of ionic compounds. Previous knowledge: in the preceding section, you have learned about formation of covalent bonds between atoms. Now, dear students, what is covalent bond? A covalent bond is the mutual sharing of electrons between two or more atoms. It is the mutual sharing of electrons between two similar atoms, or it is the mutual sharing of electrons between two dissimilar atoms. The mutual sharing of electrons between two similar atoms, for example, in H2, in which two hydrogen will share its electron and form H2. In N2, the two nitrogen will share its electron and form N2. For the dissimilar atoms, for example, the HCl, in which hydrogen and chlorine will share its electron and form hydrochloric acid, which is HCl. Intermolecular forces. Now, what are intermolecular forces? These are the forces of attraction which is created between the molecules. For example, dipole-dipole interaction and hydrogen bonding. Now, what is dipole-dipole interaction? It is the force of attraction which occurs between polar molecules. In dipole-dipole interaction, slightly negative end of polar molecule is weakly attracted to the slightly positive end of another molecule. Such attracting forces are called dipole-dipole interactions. Now, what is hydrogen bonding? The interaction of a highly electron deficient hydrogen and lone pair on a nearby highly electronegative atom such as nitrogen, oxygen or fluorine is called hydrogen bond. Dear students, our new topic is nature of bonding. Dear students, what are ionic compounds? Compounds that consist of ions joined by electrostatic forces are called ionic compounds. Now, what is ionic bond? Ionic bonds are formed between two atoms. When one atom loses electron to form cation and the other atom gains electron to form anion. Anions and cations have opposite charges. They attract one another through electrostatic forces. The forces of attraction that binds oppositely charged ions are called ionic bonds. Compounds that consist of ions joined by electrostatic forces are called ionic compounds. The total positive charge of cations must be equal to the total negative charge of the anions. This is because ionic compounds as a whole are called electrically neutral. Now, what are the properties of ionic compounds? Crystalline solid at room temperature, for example, sodium chloride. Dear students, this is the structure of crystalline sodium chloride, in which the arrangements of sodium chloride ions are shown. The sodium chloride form colorless cubic crystals. Each sodium ion is surrounded by 6 chlorine ions, and each chlorine ion is surrounded by 6 sodium ions. Thus, in crystals, each ion is attracted strongly to each of its neighbors. The large attracting forces results in a very stable structure. Properties of sodium chloride. Dear students, as I had told you that in sodium chloride, the ionic bond is present. When the sodium loses its electron, the chlorine will gain that electron. As a result, the ionic bond is formed. So, in sodium chloride crystalline structure, each sodium is surrounded by 6 chlorine ions and each chlorine ion is surrounded by 6 sodium ions. As a result, it will form colorless cubic crystal. In crystal, Each ion is attracted strongly to each of its neighbors. The large attracting forces results in a very stable structure. So ionic compounds have high melting points due to its attractive forces. For example, the melting point of sodium chloride is 801 degrees centigrade. Dear students, this is the structure of cesium chloride. In cesium chloride, the ionic bond is present, which is formed between cesium and chlorine. When cesium loses its electrons, the chlorine will gain that electron and form ionic bond between them. As a result, cesium chloride is formed. This is the crystalline structure of cesium chloride. The internal structure of cesium chloride is different from sodium chloride. In cesium chloride, each cesium positive ion is surrounded by 8 chlorine negative ions, and each chlorine negative ion is surrounded by 8 cesium positive ions. Thus, it will form a crystalline structure, which is a ionic compound, and it have also a high melting point like sodium chloride. Conduction of electricity through melted ionic compounds. How melted ionic compounds conduct electricity? Dear students, when an aqueous solution of ionic compounds conduct electricity, this is because when an ionic compound dissolves in water, the ions are free to move about in the aqueous solution. And the positive ions will move towards the negative electrode, and the negative ions will move toward the positive electrode. As a result, the electricity between electrodes in the external wire will produce. Conduction of electricity through molten sodium chloride. Dear students, in this figure, conduction of electricity through molten sodium chloride is shown. When melted ionic compounds conduct electricity, look at the figure. In this figure, sodium chloride when melts, and the sodium and chlorine ions are free to move throughout the molten salt. When sodium and chlorine ion is formed, the chlorine becomes negatively charged and sodium becomes positively charged. As a result, when voltage is applied, sodium positive ions will move towards the negative electrode, which is cathode. At the same time, the chlorine negative ions will move towards the positive electrode, which is anode. This movement of ions inside a cell is responsible for the flow of electricity between the electrodes in the external wire. As a result, electricity is produced. Recap. Dear students, in this tutorial, we have learned about what is ionic compound. Compounds that consist of ions joined by electrostatic forces are called ionic compounds. Nature of ionic compounds. That ionic compounds are crystalline solid at room temperature and it have high melting point. For example, sodium chloride have a melting point of 801 degrees centigrade. Properties of ionic compounds, that it can conduct electricity in molten state. Dear students, here are the tasks assigned for you. In exercise MCQs, page number 76, solve the MCQs in your book. Question number 14 and 16, page number 77, write the question number 14 and 16 in your neat copy, neat and clean. Thank you, dear students. Take care and Allah Hafiz.